Hello, F5 community, and welcome. I'm Aubrey, and this is a DevCentral Lightboard lesson. Today, we're going to be talking about managing your LTM clusters by using equal cost multipath routing instead of our traditional device service cluster. If you're wondering why you would do that, well, it's fairly simple. If you've got to follow a path to virtualization, your device service clusters can have a maximum of 8 members in them. And with ECMP, I've seen clusters as large as 64 members in them. So when you are looking at Virtual Edition and thinking about a device service cluster pair of LTMs, imagine if you had 64 Virtual Edition LTMs. And if they were high performance, you could have some pretty serious performance numbers with that cluster versus just a couple of Virtual Editions somewhere out there in a hypervisor. So how does this work? Well, we see a packet come down into a data center typically, and that's passed to a router. Now that router keeps in contact with, let's say we've got a group of 3 LTM devices here in our data center that we want to pass traffic through for a particular application. Each of these LTMs would have an identical configuration because we're not going to be counting on the device service cluster to maintain the configuration via a config sync. Instead, we are going to be looking at a golden source of truth, something like Ansible by Red Hat. So, if we can count on Ansible as a golden source of truth, then we don't need to worry about synchronizing a configuration, and that means that the entire configuration can be identical across all of these nodes. Well, why is that? Well, each one of them does have one unique identifier, and that is a self IP. So each of these self IPs are unique. Aside from the self IP, all of the other objects in the configuration should be identical. The virtual IPs, the pools, the pool members, all of the monitors, everything will be the same. So that's how we can count on Ansible in this equation to maintain our configurations for us. And so this would be our config. Now, we also have pool members in this environment. So let's say in this example, we have 4 servers that we want to pass traffic through that are all some particular service here. As a packet comes down into the router maintains persistence by using what's called a 5-tuple hash. Now, that 5-tuple hash keeps track of the source and destination IPs and ports. And that's how we know where the originator is of the packet. So the client is going to be out here somewhere, and it has an IP address. And also, the VIP is going to have an IP address from the router. Now, again, this VIP is all the same VIP. How is that possible? Well, each local traffic manager will ARP out its virtual IP address to the router, and the router understands that each of these LTMs are exactly one hop away from it, thus equal cost. So the router will then round robin packets in a very dumb fashion out to our LTMs where we can actually incorporate smarter load balancing. Now, how would we maintain a packet flow in this? If you're thinking persistence profile, then you definitely guessed correctly. In that way, if our packet comes down and the 5-tuple hash remembers the client as well as LTM3 on this MAC address, then the LTM will also remember that it sent its packet to server 1 in this equation. And when the packet is returned to the LTM via auto last hop and then back to the router and thus to the client, then the SYNAC, if this is a TCP application, comes back from the client, hits the router, and the router says, I have an entry in my 5-tuple hash for this flow, and I'm going to send it back to the same LTM who has a persistence profile, understanding that this packet and this flow are being handled by this particular server. This server can then ACK and complete the TCP handshake. Now, what happens in the event of a loss? Well, in terms of, let's say we lose a switch or a hypervisor or something in that manner, and our LTM here ends up disappearing. Well, what we will have then is probably another utility, such as an OpenStack heat orchestration template, that would bring up, that would have a way to bring up a new LTM as quickly as possible, and would have an understanding of that unique self-IP address that existed on that LTM. From there, Ansible would then be responsible for sending the newest form of the configuration here and standing up not only the virtual IP, but also completing the pool that exists underneath. This is how you would scale an application using equal cost multipath routing and F5 virtual edition instead of a device service cluster. Thanks for tuning in. I'm Aubrey with DevCentral. Have a great F5 day.